Salutations, spooks, spirits, and specters, and welcome back to Planetarian, the Reverie of a Little Planet, where our main character, or MC protagonist, is doing his best to recount why war never changes. The purpose of life became merely to live, and so man began to produce nothing other than man. That situation dragged on for 20 long years. It was then when the rain began to fall. Radioactive rain. The rain continued to fall without regard for day or night, snatching away even the sunlight from this world and obliterating the seasons. It poisoned the soil and the water, withered the plants, cracked concrete, and turned steel into rusty garbage. Even the act of man giving birth to man would now come to naught, or so it seemed. There was nothing left in this world but dirt immersed in poison and unspeakable ruin. For a junker like me, a sarcophagus city was like a mountain of treasure. Now, 30 years after the outbreak of the war, the artificial bacteria for which vaccines were never developed had all but died off. I gotta turn the fan off so I'm not so chilly. Even the vast sarcophagus dome that once enveloped the entirety of the city had been eroded away by the rain. However, the fact that people continued to avoid this area had not changed. When the inhabitants were ordered to evacuate, they left behind all their possessions and equipment, all the way down to their pins and needles. Thus, one could find MREs, various medicines, fuel, batteries, precision tools, weapons and ammunition, and all sorts of arcane devices in a more or less preserved state that could no longer be obtained these days in the unused air raid shelters and the destroyed military installations. What a sentence that was! And when one was very lucky indeed, one could find cases of pre-war distilled liquor and cigarettes. However, if you let your guard down for even a second, you'd quickly pay for trespassing many times over. This was guaranteed by the warmonger patrols, autonomous hedgehog hunter killer tanks and light, anti-personnel Menschenjäger drones, all of them still in extermination mode, as well as the proximity mines that could be triggered even by opening doors. Not to mention the unstable floors and scaffolding that could crumble just by stepping on them, the uncharacterizable fevers that seemed to arise from an infection with mutant bacteria, the hordes of hungry rats, and other junkers who might be better armed. The list went on and on.
封印都市にだけは近づくもんじゃない。
I remember an older junker telling me that once. That junker and I partnered up some time ago, and we worked together for about a year. My partner, whose chatter was annoying but skill as a junker couldn't be doubted, served the role of the scout and I the role of the enforcer. As we shared a drink of pre-war G&B that we had discovered together one day, my partner informed me about the existence of a few sarcophagus cities located along an unplundered strip of the East Coast. He told me about the abundant riches and untold dangers that lay therein.
だがな、 封印都市で一番厄介なのは ロボットに会っちまった時だ。
I pressed for more details, but my partner said nothing more on the matter. Instead, he repeated himself by saying, "Do not talk to it. It's not a thing that is of this world," with a grimace that further distorted his face, whose nose had already been badly disfigured by some shrapnel from a fragmentation grenade. I think my partner said a few other things, but I couldn't remember what they were anymore. Eventually, that junker got ensnared by an obvious booby trap and died, too. His final words were, "A can of sardines from my hometown brings back memories. That's why I buried my erstwhile partner along with a can of the stuff after digging his grave. At the time, I wished that his last words had been a little less desolate and a little more stoic. Even now, I continue to wish that." Oh, look at it change colors.
このように色およびパターンを変化させることができます。
Thank you for sharing that wonderful information.
私の勤続10年を記念して、館長さんとスタッフの皆さんからお送りいただいたものです。
Congratulations, robot. The most irritating thing in this entire sarcophagus city showed off her functions to me with exhaustive courtesy.
標準オプションとしましては、カード印刷機能とホログラフィック録画再生機能がイヤレシーバーに搭載されています。
This was nothing more or less than a bad joke.
カード印刷機能では、当館のプログラムと今月の天文現象案内、当デパートの祭事案内、それに周辺地図、各種割引券などをご用意できます。
Well, since there's no such thing as currency, really, I guess, anymore in this world, discount coupons are useless. She produced a card from a slot on her left ear like it was a magic trick.
どうぞ。当館のプログラムです。
I took the proffered card, opened it, and took a glance. It was an antique made of ink and paper from 30 years ago. The small letters were so severely blurred that I could barely read them, and even then, the right margins were completely illegible. As a Flowercrest rooftop planetarium this month, Planetarian projection, the autumn stars and cons. Special feature, the reverie of mankind spreading. Note, we are expecting our 2,500,000 customer.
無料ですので、遠慮なくお受け取りください。
Wow. Wow. Jeez. My foot still hurts. I decided to ignore her instead. Smiling the entire time, she cheerfully looked on as my fingers crumpled the card into a wad.
では次に、ホログラフィック録画再生機能をお見せします。お客様、当館にお越しになった記念に、ぜひ一言どうぞ。
I let out a sigh as I was confronted by this unending monologue. I had lost my gloves, so my skin had been exposed to the open air for several days. My hands up to my wrists ached as if they had been pierced by needles, no thanks to the fact that I had been out in the rain for so long. There was a single cigarette left in the waterproof case in my breast pocket. It was the last of the pack I had bartered 2 dozen cluster fuel cells for at a trading post half a year ago. Oh, so there's bartering. Okay, bartering's kind of different than just currency. As soon as I took the case out, I was struck by a terrible feeling. The front clasp was undone, and rusty brown drops of water were leaking out. I involuntarily buried my head in my hands. And just like that, I looked up at the ceiling. Today's work had been a complete waste from the very outset. First, I fought with three other junkers over the right to use the only safe way into this godforsaken place. Although I somehow managed to win, I used up half my already meager supply of ammunition doing so. Then, after breaking through the quarantine wall, I ran into an entire platoon of Menschenjags. Thanks to them, I ended up creeping, twisting, and turning inside a maze of rubble and mud for half a day. By the time I caused three of them to run aground and incapacitated the fourth, I had no more ammunition from my PDW. Hold on a second here. Stop! For my PDW, only three cartridges left for my grenade launcher, and I had totally lost my case of rations. As I surveyed the state of the city, my disappointment soared. The stores and the air raid shelters along the quarantine wall had already been broken into, and there was nothing of value to be found in those places any longer. I should have been looking to escape right around that point. But instead, I proceeded deeper in. And I will go ahead and end it here. So thank you all very much for watching, and ciao for now. Ciao for now.